Mark Gibson, male, age 28, returned from the astral plane approximately 13 minutes ago. This was his 21st dive. He's experiencing migraine-like pain, intense pressure behind the eyes, no recollection of his time in the astral plane, and appears severely disoriented. Preliminary examination revealed no immediate cause.
wish things had gone differently in ordinary for us. Wishing won't change things. Finding the projector will.
There's so much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. But the boy, Dylan Faden, prime candidate 6. And the sister as well, once we catch up with her. But the boy, so much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name. It's completely different circumstances here.
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't. All the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers, but they just stood by and watched me.
We used to play there all the time. Me and Dylan, and other kids as well.
I studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking. I were both prime candidates. Experiments.
Thank you.
We're going back home. there's a control panel nearby. There's gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby. It won't rotate. Something's blocking it. Something's blocking it. Thank you.
listening to America Overnight, celebrating 29 years, shining a light in the shadows.
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world, in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life, popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there's something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause and what's the effect? Are we the starting point or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions, or die trying.
Thank you.
slide projector in the dump outside town. Did they recreate that too? Is that where they keep it? Landfill here in the middle of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable.
Effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department, dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there, that's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next.
You mentioned a poem last time we talked. By Thomas Paine?
Yes.
Beyond the Shadow.
That's no normal piece of paper. Okay, need to know where it is.